So if, like me, you have multiple 3D printers, you might be getting a little frustrated with having to save files to an SD card and swapping them between machines. So in this video, I'll be setting up a very basic 3D printer farm. A solution I really like for a single printer is Octoprint. Octoprint, when installed on a computer or Raspberry Pi, allows remote control of the 3D printer functions. And when configured correctly, you can actually send the files directly from your slicer. So if the computer you're using has Wi-Fi, it adds flexibility, allowing you to put the printer in a more convenient place. My specific challenge is to get 3 CR10 3D printers working in this way. One thing I don't want to do is to have a Raspberry Pi per machine. So we need to find a way of getting 3 printers connected to a single Raspberry Pi, all working together. So what we're going to need to complete this project is a Raspberry Pi, the Raspbian OS, Docker, which is a containerized system which will allow us to run multiple instances of software, and Octoprint. Go off to the raspberrypi.org website to get the Raspbian OS, and once in the download section, I chose the Raspberry Pi OS Lite, which doesn't have a desktop environment because we're not going to be using a monitor on this system. A quick search for Etcher provides us a link to the website for Berliner Etcher, which is the software they're going to be using to write the SD card and prepare the Raspberry Pi for its first boot. So once the image zip has been downloaded, we extract the image file to a place where we can access it easily. After taking your blank SD card and plugging it into a card reader and inserting it into your PC, we're ready to flash the file. First, we select the image file we just previously extracted, select the target location, and then flash. Once flashing is complete, we can remove the SD card, insert it into the Raspberry Pi, and start up for the first time. For the initial setup, you will need to plug the Raspberry Pi into a monitor, and also have a keyboard plugged in. Once the Raspberry Pi has been connected to the network, we should be able to do all the administration from a remote PC. Next, we log into the Raspberry Pi using the default username and password of Pi and Raspberry. So once logged in, we run the Raspberry Pi config tool and change the default password. Next, we configure the Wi-Fi. After a reboot, we do a system update. Finally, we configure the SSH client that will allow us to connect to the Raspberry Pi remotely. So with the Raspberry Pi now configured, we can use PuTTY, an SSH client, to connect to it from a remote PC. So we can disconnect the monitor and keyboard at this point. To achieve multiple instances of Octoprint running on the Raspberry Pi without them clashing, I'm using a system called Docker. It's a virtualized container system which allows us to have multiple instances of software running simultaneously without interfering with each other. The installation of Docker is quite involved, so I won't be going into it in full detail here. However, if you check the description of this video, there'll be links to the instructions on how to get it installed. With Docker now installed, we need to get our Octoprint container from the Docker Hub library. A quick search of the Docker Hub provides us a link to Octoprint. Copy the link and paste the command into the command line of the Pi. This will complete a pull request pulling the image to the Raspberry Pi. The final piece of the puzzle is to create the configuration file, or the configuration YAML file. In here, we'll specify how many services of Octoprint will actually be running, what ports they will be running on, and also what USB ports they will have access to. Create the Docker Compose YAML file by using the nano command, copy and pasting the example in the description, and saving the file. We can then run Docker Compose and bring the service up for the first time. Once Docker Compose has started, we can now go into each instance of Octoprint and configure it for each of the printers. To access the instance of Octoprint, start by either typing the host name or the IP address of the Raspberry Pi. Then put a colon and the port number that you've specified for the instance that you'd like to configure. Now it's just a case of repeating the process for every instance of Octoprint that we have running. All barring a bit of cable management, the physical setup is now complete. All that remains to configure the slicer, so it will send the files directly to the instance of Octoprint that we're interested in. I use Simplify3D, and combined with printer profiles, it makes it relatively straightforward, providing you have curl installed on your Windows operating system. To send a file to a specific instance of Octoprint, add the command that's in the description to the script section of your printer setup. Now whenever we slice a file and we save the G-code, it will send it directly to the 3D printer and prepare it for printing. Remember, insert your API key, your IP address and port numbers to ensure that it works for you. This is going to be a big quality of life improvement using the 3D printers. No longer will I have to send the files across to the printer using an SD card, I can send them wirelessly. In the future, I'll be adding cameras and also the ability to be able to turn each printer on independently without even having to be here. So pop in the comments if you've got any feedback for me in terms of my setup, and don't forget to like and subscribe, and I'll catch you in the next video.